Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about Entity Framework Core and REST API methods. REST APIs are mostly used nowadays because it gives you freedom to write your client in any language. And tomorrow, if you do not like your technology where you have written your UI, and you can switch to any other technology because most of your code is written in your REST API. And if you have a lot of data like Google, Reddit, Facebook, Twitter, then you can write documentation of your API and sell this API to people and make some money through it. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about how you can write get, post, put, delete methods in your ASP.NET web API. And then using Entity Framework Core, you can update data in your database. Let's jump into our demo. So in my last couple of videos, I scaffolded my database and created DB context and models. And then I created authors controller to add, update, remove, and get all authors from the database. And this is where you write your delete, post, which is create method, put, which is update method in the controller. But I'm not gonna write these methods. I'm gonna let my Visual Studio write these methods. To do that, I'm gonna go to my controllers folder and then add a controller and say that it's an API controller with actions using Entity Framework. Here, it will ask me the model class for which I wanna create the controller. I'm gonna select publisher because I already have authors controller. And then it will ask me the DB context that I wanna select. There's only one DB context. And you can also name your controller here. I'm gonna keep it publisher controller. And when I click on add, it will create all these methods for me to call. And that's what I like about Visual Studio. The only thing that I had to do is to design my database and everything else is scaffolded for me. Let's check out this controller. You can see that it has HTTP get method, which is getting all the publishers. Then it has another get method, which is getting a publisher using an ID. And there's a put method, which is letting us update a publisher using ID. And there is a post method, which is letting us create a new publisher, add a new publisher in the database. And then finally, there is a delete publisher, which is just taking an ID and deleting the publisher. Cool. Before I run this, I wanna change a couple of things. One thing is I'm gonna copy this URL and put it in my launch settings so that when I run this application, it goes to publisher API. And second thing, I wanna open up my publisher table, show table data here so that I know what is getting pulled. Alright, you can see in our publisher table there is publisher name, city, state, and country of the publisher. Cool, let's run this and see what happens. So when I run it, it goes to API publisher URL and it lists down all the publishers from the database. And I did not have to write any code for that. I just had to add a controller using API controller wizard. Okay, I wanna show one more thing here before I test this API. You can see that in the publisher controller which got created, it's taking bookstore DB context as a parameter in the constructor. And this constructor, this context is getting injected in the controller. For that, I had to go in my startup file here and define which is that DB context. Because publisher controller does not know what context is this to perform the operation. So you'll have to go to your startup page and in services, when the application starts, add a DB context saying that bookstore DB context is the DB context that I want to use for performing the operation. And then you have to pass the connection string for the DB context. Okay, now let's go ahead and test our API now. For testing this API, what I've done, I have installed this Postman tool. I think this is one of the best tools which you can use for testing your API. So I'm gonna add a tab here and put my URL here, and I'm gonna use a get method and click on send. When I click on send, you can see that it lists on all the publishers from my database. Okay, now what I wanna test my get function by ID. So to do that, I'm gonna say 5 in front of my URL and click on send. And then you can see that it's listing the publisher who has publisher ID 5. And you can also see that it's maintaining the history of all my calls so that I can go back and test my API if I want to. All right, now we can get all the publishers, get publisher by ID. I wanna create a new publisher. To do that, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select a post method here and then get rid of this 5 ID, go to body. I have copied this JSON, go to body, select raw, paste the JSON, select JSON format here, and I'm gonna get rid of this public publisher ID here because I auto-generate, auto-increment my primary key. And in publisher name, I'm gonna say Egmont Books is my new publisher. And I'm gonna keep city, state, country the same. Okay, let's run this and see what happens. When I click on send, it gives me a JSON back saying that it created a new publisher with publisher ID 12. Let's go in our database table here. And now we do not have anybody with 12 ID. When I refresh it, you can see that Egmont Books got added in my publisher table. Okay, what if I want to change this to Boston? It's not really Dallas. I want to update my new entry here. To update, what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this JSON again. And instead of post, I'm going to select put. And here, I'm going to pass the ID 12. And in body, I'm gonna paste my object again. And instead of Dallas, I'm gonna say it's from Boston. This publisher is from Boston. And I'm gonna click on send. And it's not returning anything, but if I refresh my table, you can see that it updated the city of Egmont Books to Boston. Okay, so we covered get all, get by ID, created a new publisher, then updated that new publisher. Now I wanna delete this publisher. Delete is pretty simple. You go to this dropdown, select delete, and pass the ID that you want to delete, and click on send. And that will return the object which is deleted. When I refresh my database here, you can see the 12 ID Egmont Books is gone now, it's deleted. Okay, so this is how easy it is to add a controller and perform the basic operations on your database using ASP.NET Core Web API. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter or Facebook, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching this video.